Hello friends, today we are going to study sampling methods in research methodology. Sampling is a process used in statistical analysis in which a predetermined number of observations are obtained from a large population. The methodology used to collect samples from a larger population depends on the type of analysis being performed. Following sampling methods we are going to study in detail. Please watch my video till end because you will find different examples in each and every point we are going to study today. Category A, probability sampling method. Probability sampling is a sampling technique in which samples are collected in a process that offers all individuals in the population an equal chance of being selected. In these sampling techniques, the researcher must ensure that every individual has the same selection opportunity. Let us study types of probability sampling in detail. Number 1. Simple random sampling. Simple random sampling is a sampling technique in which each item in the population has an equal chance and probability of being selected from the sample. Here, the selection of item depends completely on chance or probability. And therefore, this sampling technique is also known as method of chances. If, as a researcher, you want to save time and money, simple random sampling is one of the best probability sampling method you can use. For example, a hospital has 1,000 employees and they need to allocate the night shift to 100 members. All employee names will be put in a bucket to be selected at random, as each person has the same chance of being selected. Number 2. Systematic sampling. Systematic sampling is defined as a probability sampling method in which the researcher chooses elements from a target population by selecting a random starting point and selecting other member after a fixed sampling interval. The researcher calculates the sampling interval by dividing the total population size by the desired sample size. Systematic sampling is an extended implementation of probability sampling in which each member of the group is selected at regular interval to form a sample. For example, if a group of students were being sampled to gain their opinion on college facilities, then administration department make central list of all students and arrange in such a way that the sex of student alternate between male and female, and choosing student at an even interval, for example, every 20th student would result in a sample of all male or all females. Number 3. Stratified sampling. In this method, the population is first divided into subgroups or strata that share a similar characteristics. Strata can be divided based on age, sex, income level, occupation, education, or region. It is used when we can reasonably expect the measure of interest to vary between different subgroups and we want to ensure representation of all subgroups. For example, in a study of health outcome of the nursing staff in a country, if there are 3 hospitals, each with different number of nursing staff, Hospital A has 500 nurses, Hospital B has 1,000, and Hospital C has 2,000. It would be appropriate to choose the sample number for each hospital proportionately. For example, 10 from Hospital A, 20 from hospital B and 40 from hospital C. These ensure a more realistic and accurate estimate of nurses' health outcome across the country. Number 4. Clustered sampling. In clustered sampling, subgroups of the population are used as a sampling unit rather than individuals. The population is divided into subgroups known as clusters, which are selected randomly to be included in the study. Each cluster can be treated as small population that have all the attributes of the population. Cluster sampling can be more efficient than simple random sampling, especially when a study takes place in a wide geographical region. For example, researcher who is looking to understand the smartphone use by the college students of arts in India. If there are 200 colleges with approximately 5,000 students, here few colleges will be randomly selected, say 10 colleges, and all the students of these 10 colleges are interviewed. Category B, non-probability sampling. Non-probability sampling is defined as a sampling technique in which the researcher selects samples based on the researcher's subjective judgment and not random selection. Non-probability sampling is a sampling method in which not all members of the population have the same chance to participate in the study. Let us study types of non-probability sampling in detail. Number 1. Convenience sampling. Convenience sampling is a non-probability sampling technique in which samples are selected from the population only because they are conveniently available to the researcher. Researcher choose this sample just because they are easy to recruit, and the researcher did not consider selecting a sample that represents the entire population. It is also used in pre-testing a questionnaire. Sometimes when quick reaction to a product concept are needed to know its value, convenience sampling is useful. For example, in mall, researcher stands at a prominent point and interviews all those who pass through that place. Number 2. Quota sampling. Quota sampling is defined as a non-probability sampling method in which researcher create a sample involving individuals who represent a population. Researcher choose these individuals according to specific characteristics or qualities. In quota sampling, the population is classified in number of groups based on some criteria such as age, gender, education, income, and location. Ideally, the quota chosen would proportionally represent the characteristics of the underlying population. For example, a cigarette company wants to find out which age group prefer which brand of cigarette in a specific city. Researcher applies quota in the age group of 21 to 30, 31 to 40, 41 to 50, and 51 years or older. From this information, the researcher assesses the smoking trend among the city's population. Number 3. Judgment or purposive sampling. This technique depends on the researcher's judgment when choosing who to ask to participate. Researcher can thus implicitly choose a representative sample to meet their needs or specifically target individuals with certain characteristics. This approach is often used by the media when collecting opinions from the public in search of opinions and qualitative research. For example, many companies often try out new product ideas on their own employees, who are more favorable to new ideas than general public. If the product does not pass this group, it does not have prospect for success in general market. Number 4. Snowball sampling. Snowball sampling is a technique where a researcher picks the first few samples and either recruits them or asks them to recommend other subjects they know who fit the description of samples needed. This method is commonly used in social sciences when investigating hard to reach groups. Existing subjects are asked to nominate further subjects known to them, so the sample increases in size like rolling snowball, which rolling down a hill until the researcher has sufficient data to analyze. Snowball sampling is also called chain referral sampling. For example, a researcher looking to study patterns of informal leadership in a community may ask people to name other influential people in a community. Friends, thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, then please subscribe to my channel Management by Dr. Mitul Dhimber and share my videos. Thank you.